right, and joining us now for In Focus for his thoughts on the Moreno-Robredo controversy, we have Senator Coco Pimentel. Senator Pimentel is, of course, the head of the PDP Laban Pacquiao Wing. Senator, nice to see you again. Thanks for joining us. Good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, Carmina, and to all of your viewers.
All right, we're going to talk about that Easter press con in a bit. But first, I want to ask you, how would you describe the campaign of Senator Manny Pacquiao at this point in the campaign period?
Yes, we are doing very well, and crowds are getting bigger. Our candidate and his supporters are getting more inspired because of the feedback from the ground.
And the feedback is?
Feedback is they're excited to see presidential candidate Manny Pacquiao, and they are filling up our pabahay forms and getting their IDs, their pabahay IDs.
Tell us more about that. What are those pabahay IDs and forms?
That's the main program of government of Senator Manny Pacquiao for president. We call it the Pabahay Plus program. Ginagamit lang po yung pabahay as the word, but it's actually libreng pabahay sa mga homeless, trabaho, pangkabuhayan, health and education, and other basic needs. Yun po ang programa po ni Senator Manny Pacquiao pag maging presidente ng Republika ng Pilipinas, sagutin, address the basic needs of the people, especially the poor.
So he
has that insight. Galing siya sa kahirapan, alam niya na yan ang hinihingi ng ating mga kababayan na lubog sa hirap ngayon.
So when they fill up those forms, what exactly are they going to get in exchange?
They are now in our database, the database of the Pacquiao team. Once we win, if Senator Pacquiao becomes president, then automatically we activate the database. Okay, we look at the database for government programs. If the requested, kung ang inihinging programa ay pabahay, then they will be put in the pabahay program. If kailangan ng trabaho, hanapan ng trabaho yan, pangkabuhayan, edukasyon or kalusugan or etc. Kung mayroon pang specific na request na sinulat po doon sa pabahay form. So ganyan po yung aming gagawin. It's a database. And it will be activated on day one of the Pacquiao presidency.
Okay, you call it a database, but how can this not be seen as sort of a belated way of vote buying?
Well, it's not vote buying because there is no material item being given during the campaign. And it's a program of government. Everybody, all candidates, express their program of government. Kami na lang po, we took an extra step so that on day one, we are very ready to execute our program of government. But it's a program of government, mga kababayan. Pabahay program of Senator Manny Pacquiao.
Senator, is this where you want the campaign to be at this point? We're just a few weeks away from May 9.
From our point of view, yes. I think we are now reaching, as I compared our campaign to an airplane taking off. So I think we are now reaching now our cruising altitude. That is the highest point in the flight of an airplane.
So, well, following your analogy, Senator Pimentel, that plane was delayed in taking off. You're only now taking off
a few more weeks before
May 9?
We took off from the very start, but of course we came from the ground, and then we know we have to reach our cruising altitude at the right time. And that with 2 weeks to go, I think we're now reaching our cruising altitude. And God willing, with God's help and the people's help, that peak moment should be a winning number or a winning percentage already.
Talk to us about the turbulence encountered during this flight of yours, Senator Pimentel. What were the challenges that you met during the on the campaign trail?
Well, of course, since this is a presidential candidate, you have very few people who are experienced in presidential candidates. The problems are more of coordination, logistics, you know, we decided very early on to, if there is no politician, local politician, or who wants to be identified with us, we will jump over that person and go directly to the people. So this presented more logistical problems or more logistical difficulties, but we were able to do it. Our crowds are big enough also.
Mm-hmm. And months into the campaign season, do you feel like you have your message strong enough now and more coherent? Because in the beginning, you were sort of introducing Manny Pacquiao to the public as Manny Pacquiao, the politician, and not the boxer that the people have grown to love. But now we see a change in tactics. Was that a learning? Was that a learning point for the campaign, Senator?
That was part of the plan, actually. But we never changed the main message of communicating the pillar, his main pillar of the program of government, which is the Pabahay Plus. It's really the Pabahay Plus program. Basta ramdam ni Senator Manny Pacquiao ang problema ng pinakamahirap nating kababayan, kaya yun ang unahin niyang solusyonan o sagutin o tugunan. Hmm. So yun po yun, captured po yun sa tinatawag naming Pabahay Plus program. So yun, the basic needs. Pabahay, bakit pabahay kagad ang naisip? Because it represents dignity, human dignity. Meron kang dignidad kung meron kang bubong over your head, eh. Kung meron kang sarili mong tahanan. So sabi nga namin, sa maayos na lipunan, dapat kada mamayan may sariling tahanan. So yun po yun. Tapos sunod-sunod na po yan, Carmina. Mm. Pabahay for human dignity, then siyempre trabaho, human dignity din po yan. Pangkabuhayan, kalusugan, edukasyon, etc. Kung meron pang specific na nahiling ang ating mga kababayan.
Because really, when you talk about it, Senator Pimentel, once you have that sense of ownership, whether you're talking about business or even how small that business is, or owning that roof over your heads, that's potentially life-changing for a lot of people.
That's correct. And then, pag sinabi nga namin the poorest of the poor, marami tayong mga kababayang mahihirap. Pero sino ang pinakamahirap? Yung nasa lansangan, napapalakad-lakad lang doon, yun ang pinakakawawa sa lahat. So, ang una natin gawin talaga, pabahay. Kasi marami rin naman tayong kababayan na mayroong tinitirhan pero hindi nila pag-aari, di ba? They're renting or they don't have rights to the land. Ayusin dapat yan. Dapat sariling tahanan. Sa maayos na lipunan, lahat dapat may sariling tahanan.
So you said a while ago that this is going to form a database so that from day one, you're going to move on with your the next step of your plan. But how fast is the turnaround here?
Well, ganito yan eh. As far as our database is concerned, andyan na siya. I think we have millions already of names, contact numbers, and addresses. So, and then the second step is that Senator Manny Pacquiao has found around 300 to 400 billion pesos in the national budget which we can use for the Pabahay Plus program. Kasi ang suspecha namin doon na nanakaw lang po yun, nawawala lang po yun sa katiwalian. O di ba? So 300 to 400 billion, that represents around 1 to 1.5 million homes kung maayos ang paggagamit. So yun po yun. So we have done our homework. We are ready to execute it. Kailangan manalo lang po ang Team Pacquiao.
A while ago, you were talking about the challenges that you've met during this campaign season, and you mentioned coordination and logistics. While that amounts to some of the problems that you encountered, that sort of was the solution, in a way, for last Sunday's press conference. Because of that, the senator wasn't able to attend that press conference. Tell us more about what you know about that press conference. Who initiated it, Senator Pimentel?
Well, Carmina, I was not in the loop, no, about that press con. I was informed Saturday around early evening. Sabi ko, what's the agenda? Mm. No one can. The person who informed me could not even tell me what would be the agenda. And then Senator Manny Pacquiao Saturday night flew to Mindanao and then took off at 11 a.m. I think from General Santos City. So I think he had no plans to attend. That's from the developments which happened Saturday evening. He flew back to Mindanao and then he left Mindanao at 11 a.m. The press conference was at 11 a.m. So that means that maybe he had really no intention of attending that press conference.
So
mabuti na rin yung Carmina, because if ako, I advise the group, do not attend if we do not know what the agenda is.
Mm. Were you suspicious from the get-go?
Yes. A gathering of presidential candidates, many of them in one press conference, has the potential of really exploding and turning into a fiasco, because they are all presidential candidates and they would want the spotlight to be focused on himself or herself, diba? So that's not really a brilliant idea or even a good idea, unless they wrote down the agreement, the agenda, and they signed on the agreement.
Senator, I did some digging, and people that I've talked to said that not even the senator's inner circle knew about the press conference. But he did send some of his representatives there, although they didn't go into the room. So it was really something that was, I think, kept between and among those who were supposed to be present at that press conference. What does that tell you?
Maybe it was rushed. It's a spur of the moment agreement among them. But you know, I counseled the person who informed me to tell Senator Manny Pacquiao not to attend because we do not know the agenda.
Mm.
As simple as that, Carmina.
Mm-mm.
If you do not know the agenda of an event you're going to, and also to be with you are your fellow presidential candidates, do not go because you do not know what will happen.
Okay, clarify that for us, Senator Pimentel. Didn't know the agenda. Were you only talking to that person within the team? Is it possible that that person himself didn't know about the agenda, but the senator knew? Or are you telling us that even the senator didn't know what the agenda was going to be?
No, the person I talked to, who informed me. So my reaction was that tell the team or tell Senator Manny Pacquiao not to attend because we do not know the agenda.
Mukhang nakinig po sa inyo.
Well, hindi sa akin nakinig kasi he flew back to Mindanao Saturday night and left Jensen at 11 a.m. when the press con is at 11 a.m. What do the acts tell you? If you add up all the acts, the conclusion I get is that he never intended to attend.
Or nakinig sa inyo or naparating.
Whether nakinig sa akin o hindi, basta yun po yung mga acts na nandun. So sabi ko, mabuti na lang at tama naman talaga. I mean, tingnan mo, look at what happened. So
yeah.
Now the two other participants claim that they were caught off guard by the pronouncement of one participant. So ganun po talaga yun, because you are all presidential candidates. It's a press conference during the campaign. So what would be the agenda that each of you would try to capture the spotlight towards yourself? So yun po. Ganun po ang that's logic tells us that it's a dangerous event to go to if the agenda is not really formally agreed upon.
Well, as it turns out now, part of the agenda was Vice President Lenny Robredo. Can you tell me, Senator Pimentel, what is your campaign's experience with the Vice President's campaign?
We are not really interacting. We are running our campaigns autonomously. So they haven't
sent feelers that were officially sanctioned by the VP or her campaign team for the senator to withdraw.
Not to me. So, and since it has not reached me, that means if ever this has happened, it has not been. Taken up seriously considered. Wala. So parang kwentuhan lang siguro yan. So just like what we're doing is that I know they want to win, so they're running their campaign, they have their own plan. Ganun din po kami. We have our own plan. That's why ulit-ulit lang po kami. Basta ang main pillar sa programa de gobyerno ni Senator Manny Pacquiao, if he becomes president, pabahay program.
How difficult
basic needs of the people ang kanyang sasagutin.
How difficult has it been for the campaign given that his running mate Congressman Lito Atienza has been sidelined due to surgery?
It's difficult for Vice Presidential candidate Lito Atienza. I hope he takes advantage of technology na lang, online campaigning, mga online interviews or online rallies, e-rallies. The team handling the vice presidential campaign of Lito Atienza should come up with concepts like this one, e-rally, e-campaigns. But si Senator Manny Pacquiao is full of energy. For the 90-day campaign, puno ang schedule niya. He has sorties, physical activities, and during the days na wala, he would go online and meet his group or grant interviews. So he's physically fit. He's an 8 division world champion. Wala pong makakasabay diyan sa physical fitness po ng aming kandidato si Senator Manny Pacquiao.
Senator Pimentel, remember before he declared his bid for the presidency, there was a lot of speculations as to who his running mate will be. Is it true, Senator, that the vice president asked Senator Pacquiao to keep that vice presidential post open only to declare her bid for the presidency later on?
Well, I think the person in the know, it would be our campaign manager, Buddy Zamora. But may mga narinig ako na parang tampo-tampo doon, pero anyway, tapos na po yun. Let the people decide now who would be the best leader for our country for the next 6 years.
Anong tampo-tampo po?
Well, we better ask us kasi Mr. Buddy Zamora po, may naririnig ako ng mga parang may tampo na some of our decisions were delayed because of some statements that they heard, but not me. I have no personal knowledge, Carmina. So but at any rate, tapos na po yan. That's more than 100 days ago na. So ano na po tayo? Let's concentrate on the election. We have launched our respective candidacies. May sariling buhay na po yung ating mga kampanya. May mga mensahe na tayo. Basta kami sa kampo ni Senator Manny Pacquiao, pabahay program, yung mga nakapag-sign na ng pabahay form, yung nabigyan na ng ID, itago po ninyo yung IDs niyo, yung pabahay IDs. At we will activate the program on day one of the Pacquiao presidency.
Senator Pimentel, there's another issue that's cropping up, and it's not about Senator Pacquiao's presidential bid, but the bid of your wife as party list representative for PDP Cares. I want to ask you about that. How can the humanitarian arm of your party be a party list group?
That is a misinformation campaign, Carmina, and I am sad that you fell for it, or some have fallen for it.
What do you mean?
The PDP in PDP Cares means Filipino dapat paglingkuran. That is the meaning. That is not.
So which sector are you representing there?
The vulnerable. Vulnerable sectors to natural and man-made calamities. Kasi ang nabuhay kasi itong PDP Cares dahil sa ako mismo sa Fairlane subdivision sa Marikina, nabaha kami. So alam ko yan, yung Undoy. Tapos pati si Ulysses, 2 times in 11 years. Mm. Yung sinatawag nila na once in a lifetime event. Ngayon si Kat naman, ang family niya, De Guzman of Marikina, taga Provident Village naman in Marikina. So na Undoy, hindi pa kami magkakilala noon, pero na Undoy din sila, na trap sila ron sa bahay nila, and then na Ulysses din, andun naman yung daddy niya nung.
So ginamit niyo lang po yung pangalan ng PDP.
For name recall. Yeah, may sarili siyang meaning eh. Ang meaning niya, Pilipino dapat paglingkuran. Ang daming mga
and this is separate and distinct from the humanitarian arm of PDP Laban. Because meron din, hindi ba?
Because PDP Cares is it is an incorporated entity with the SEC. It's really different. It's totally different. So yan po ang ibig sabihin ng PDP sa PDP Cares. Pilipino dapat paglingkuran.
You say it's totally different, but some are saying it's totally the same. You're becoming totally the same with other political families out there, that this is dynastic, this move to field your wife. How is this not dynastic, Senator?
The party list seat, mga kababayan, belongs to the entity, the party. So that institution will outlast me. It will outlast my wife. It will belong to the group running the institution, that party list. And the membership should come from the vulnerable sectors of society, vulnerable to natural calamities, even man-made calamities, and those who agree with the 8-point legislative agenda of PDP Cares. Those who believe that the Pilipino dapat paglingkuran.
Finally, Senator Pimentel, what's the game plan to the finish line? What can we expect from the campaign of Senator Pacquiao?
Oh, we will finish strong, Carmina. Senator Manny Pacquiao is now going to, or maybe right now, is already in Bohol and Cebu. So Visayas and Mindanao would be the last leg of the campaign, because Senator Manny Pacquiao is the only Cebuano and Ilonggo-speaking presidential candidate, Carmina. So we will finish strong in the Visayas and Mindanao region.
All right, and we're going to have to leave it at that. Senator Coco Pimentel there.
Thank you.
Joining us this afternoon. Thanks again. Pleasure talking to you. Take care. Keep safe.
Thank you. Bye-bye.